And welcome back to the Coach's Perspective here on Riverside TV, as we have our first coach, the head coach at Capistrano Valley out in the Orange County District, as they are going to play John W. North this Friday night. He is the coach, Sean Curtis. How are you doing today, Coach?
I'm doing good. Thanks for having me.
Well, Coach, I'll tell you what, this playoffs are here. You know, we're looking at, a powerhouse at Capo Valley. You guys have been great for a long time. You've played a daunting schedule. Can you tell us a little bit about your team that we can look forward to on Friday night?
Yeah, I appreciate that. I'm really proud of this team, the way we've kind of responded to adversity throughout the whole year. Like we were talking about earlier, we played a really tough schedule, some really good opponents. Almost every single game has came down to the last few minutes. So we always preach being a family, sticking together, getting over adversity. And this team has done that game in and game out. So we're excited for the playoffs. Feel like we've been building for this moment all year.
Now, what kind of style do you guys like to play? I mean, you know, North is kind of a smash mouth. Defensively, they can throw the football, run. What is your kind of style that you guys play over there?
Yeah, it's probably a clash of two different styles. We do air it out a lot. Trey Kukuk, our quarterback, is one of the best in the county. He's got the most yards, most passing touchdowns, runs for a lot of touchdowns. So he's been doing great all year, getting it to our receivers. We have three really good receivers that are putting up huge numbers. So we kind of build our offense around that. And defensively, we're 4-2-5. We like to try to do some different things with pressuring teams and things in coverage. But for the most part, you know, we're that Orange County type team that's going to throw the ball. You got to respect that. And, you know, when teams try to take that away, we do feel like our running element, especially with a mobile quarterback, can be threatening to most defenses. But the smash mouth, you know, the powerhouse type football that JW North plays, is, I have a lot of respect for that. You know, being a coach from Jay Serra, worked under Pat Harlow, ran a lot of power and counter and you know, getting after it up front. So I definitely, you know, have that type of mindset that we're trying to get our team to buy into as well.
Well, Coach, you guys played, like I said, you played a great schedule, or you know, throughout the season. You didn't play anybody lower than a D5 club. In fact, you played Santiago out here, and I'll tell you, that's a pretty good team. I mean, they came from, they came from the Big 8 League out here in the Inland Empire. What do you take? Do you always play these tough schedules? Is that what you want going into preseason?
Yeah, I think it has to be. You know, out here, our league, we got El Toro, Tribuco, Aliso, all really good teams in the CVU League. And we have an eight-team, kind of two-team league, two-division league, where you will bump up to play Mission Viejo, Tesoro, San Clemente, San Juan Hills. So to prepare yourself for league, you really do have to play quality opponents. We had a really good run for like 3-4 years before I got here, being in the semifinals, being in the finals. You know, the teams that will pick up the phone for my phone call to play are pretty few, far in between. So, you know, we like to challenge ourselves week in and week out. And, you know, we have a lot of respect for the programs that do, you know, sign on to play us. But I think if you're going to have that type of mindset that you want to go far in the playoffs, you want to win league championships, you got to have a schedule that's going to prepare you for that in the regular season.
Now, Coach, you're from a football background. You played at Northwood High School, I believe. And I think you play for your dad. Is that what happened?
I did. So, yeah, my dad's been a coach in the area for almost 40 years. I was supposed to go to Mission Viejo High School, but I went up and played for him at Northwood. Dan Selway was my quarterback, who's my offensive coordinator for me now here. So kind of a football family for sure.
Yeah, in fact, I think the Selway family has some Riverside connections. So I've known the Selway family for a number of years. Good guys.
Yeah, they are. We were talking about I believe his older brother, Rob, played JW North in the pond for some basketball, CIF finals, things like that. So there's a little bit of a Riverside connection for sure.
Well, Coach, can you tell us a little bit about what you've seen? I know you've watched film on North, but what scares you the most about the Huskies?
I mean, their run game is no joke. They have two really good running backs that get after, you know, the big bruiser back 30, and then number four is really special. It gets in space. He's really talented too. The quarterback does a good job of taking care of the ball. They don't really do a whole lot to turn the ball over for you. So You know, I think offensively they're definitely going to have some weapons that we're going to have to contain. Defensively, they have a really good core at linebacker. You know, the two brothers that are in there, they're special. They run around, they hit people, they like to get physical. So there's the aspect that we're going into the game with that, you know, we're going to play our style. And if they're going to try to match our style with being a spread offense and covering us in space, then we feel like we have the advantage. If they, you know, come out and they want to try to smash us and be powerhouse football, we're going to respond with, you know, the guys that we've trusted in the trenches all year to buckle down and do what they can to slow them down. I think at the end of the day, it's anytime you play an undefeated team, you got to get off to a good start. You got to play clean football. You know, we can't have penalties. We can't have turnovers because they're really rolling right now. Their confidence is high. Their momentum is high. So for us to come in and get off to a good start is key.
Well, Coach, we look forward to seeing you guys Friday night as you guys come out to the Inland Empire to the City of Riverside and battle John W. North High School. He is the head coach of the Capistrano Valley Cougars. He's Sean Curtis. Thank you again. We'll see you Friday night, Coach. We're now joined by the head coach at 3rd in Chicago, the North Huskies, O.P. Vaiapulu. Coach, how are you doing?
Good. How's it going?
Thanks
for having me.
Hey, no problem. Things are going great. I'll tell you what, 10-0 sounds really, really good, doesn't it, Coach?
Yeah, it's awesome, man. The kids put in a lot of great work in the offseason, and you know, they enjoy their fruits of labor. Now it's the new season right here, so hopefully we keep it going.
Well, Coach, we're in week 11, and I'll tell you what, you know, we've talked about your offense, your defense. We've talked about the entire North Husky team. You guys are just playing on all cylinders. Let's start with your defense first. They have been phenomenal all season long. I called them the criminal defense attorneys. Tell us a little bit about those guys.
Yeah, the linebackers led by Leo Tupo and Devon Toki and Johnny Tupo. Like I said, alluded to in earlier interviews, man, just the continuity of the scheme, and then those guys put in work with the rest of their teammates in the offseason and for the spring has really helped us gel on defense. And then obviously the guys up front and behind them, and they all kind of work together. It's been great to see them fly around and play football.
Well, Coach, you guys played a pretty tough non-league season. Did that really prepare you for a team like Capo Valley, who you play this week? Because Capo Valley is a no-joke team. They've had a great history, but you guys have taken care of Summit. You've taken care of some really good teams. Was that in the mindset going into this season?
Yeah, for sure. I think when we schedule teams, you know, obviously it changes year to year, but they're a solid team. You try to have a solid schedule. And I definitely those teams you named were good opponents for us and got us ready. Obviously, Capo Valley is going to be a great challenge for us. I think we're up for it, but they're, you know, they have a lot of tradition. They're a proud program. They're you know, they're not new to coming out here to IE. They've been out here to King, they've been out here to Cajon. So hopefully, you know, we come out here to the east side and we can give them a great game and continue on.
Well, let's talk about them. I'm sure you've seen them on film. What perplexes you the most about that offense, that high-powered offense?
Yeah, I mean, it starts with their quarterback. You know, that guy's, I think, threw for 600 yards one game. So they're a high-scoring, high-efficient efficiency offense. They like to throw the ball, obviously, probably 80 to 20. So it's kind of different from some of the teams we've seen earlier on in the season, at least defensively. I think we're up for a challenge. I mean, they present a great challenge with that quarterback. He has great receivers they throw to and a good line that protects them. Obviously, in these playoffs this year, I mean, it's pretty even across. I mean, if you're in the playoffs, you're pretty good. So we're not going to take them lightly. We're going to put in the work and hopefully do enough to come out on top.
Well, Coach, you know, your offense has been stellar all season long. Let's led by your quarterback, Gamble. Tell us a little bit about him. Tell us a little bit about the other offensive players. You got Venasio, Mekaele, who's another phenomenal running back who we've seen for 4 years now. But let's go a little bit in depth about, you know, about Gamble, about some of your Granger, your wide receiver. Some of those guys are the big playmakers for you.
Yeah, for sure. Like Jaden, again, this will be his second year if you want to cap the spring. He split time in the spring, and so he immersed himself over the summer in the offense and with the rest of the receivers. I think just all of them together putting in the work in, over the summer and the spring, you know, we're getting to see their fruits of labor. And obviously, they're all talented. You know, Shar obviously is a big time receiver. He's tall, he's athletic. And then you have Damian Ayala, his slot receiver. He's shorter, but he can get loose. And then Jeremiah Calhoun on the other side is just as tall and athletic. Doesn't get as many balls, you know, but they're all athletic and they all have talent. And then obviously, when you go down to the run game, CO and Hassan are pretty good. So you can't go wrong with any of those guys. And Jaden's job has just been to make the right football play and get us in the right play every time. So far, it's worked, and hopefully we can clean up little mistakes here and there and keep going.
Well, Coach, you know, this is your back in the head coaching job. You were at Poly before. What has made this year so special for you coming back to North and leading this team not only to a 10-0 record, but to the playoffs?
It's always good second time around, obviously, and North has been known for great excellence in sports. You know that. Everyone knows that out here in Riverside, and especially the football program. And really just the kids, man. You know, this last 2 years with the whole COVID thing, a lot of people could have quit and, you know, went about their lives and stuff. But these guys kept fighting, kept putting the work, kept hoping for things, great things to come and good things to come. And now, as you see, you know, we had a 10-0 record, unblemished, and going into the playoffs with a great opportunity to come out with a W on Friday. You know, so that's what I'm most proud of. And I'm apart from before, you know, just these guys coming out with all the adversity going on, just outside of football, but in life in general, and they're coming together, working together, and they're coming out 10-0. They're ready to hopefully have a great playoff run.
Well, Coach, I'm friends with a number of North alumni, and everybody's either texted me or called me and said, hey, are you on the North call? And I said, you're darn right I'm on the North call. I can't miss out on the number one ranked team in our city. And I'll tell you, what is the feeling like on the North campus? I mean, you have the Blue Star Regiment, which is one of the best bands in the entire world. And what is the feeling like around campus? I mean, are people as excited as they are in the community? Because I'm hearing a lot of it right now.
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it's nothing new to the community, obviously. You know, again, this campus has history of being excellent in all sports, especially football with Coach Praise and Coach Randall, obviously. But yeah, it's back then. You know, I think it's true for every school where if the football team is doing a good job and the campus starts off the year great, I think. The community, I mean, that's part of why the reason why we're so successful is that we have so much support just on campus from the staff and the community off campus. And so when they work together with a great community like the Eastside is with North, and great admin, and you have great players, a coach, it makes it easier and it gives us chances to come out and have the success that we have right now.
Well, Coach O.P. Viapulu, it's always great catching up with you and the John W. North Huskies. Ghazal Hassan and I will be on the call Friday night at 7 p.m., and we're hoping for a victory for the Huskies. Go Huskies, and go Coach Viapulu. He's the coach.
Awesome. Thanks for having me.
We'll be right back here on Riverside TV. And welcome back to another edition of the Coach's Perspective here on Riverside TV. It's playoff time, week one here. And I'll tell you what, we have a couple great games on the docket this week for the city of Riverside. First, we have the Ramona Rams versus Valley Chrisitian out of Cerritos. And then the granddaddy of them all, the number one ranked team in Riverside, J.W. North's going to take on Capo Valley out of the Orange County. We are now joined by my partner in crime, my friend, my confidant, my all-time favorite, Ghazal Hassan. How you doing, Ghazal?
It's a veritable bouillabaisse, Jeff. Five Riverside teams. We need the count from Sesame Street here. Five Riverside teams. You kind of look like the count. Five Riverside teams in the CIF playoffs. Two of them are at home. So we'll have both on Riverside TV. You and I are calling John W. North Capo Valley. The great Nick Rice and J.R. Abar will be on the call for Ramona and Valley Chrisitian. Should be an exciting Friday night of high school football.
Well, Ghazal, we've covered, you know, all these teams in Riverside from 1 to 9. And I'll tell you what, Who's the best team we saw all season long? It's third in Chicago, JW North. They have been formidable. They have been tough. And they start off with a great opponent in Capitol Valley, don't they?
Yeah, well, first of all, it's the playoffs, right? So there are no bad teams. You're not going to get a bad team. Every matchup is going to be tough. But the styles are going to be interesting. And I'll tell you what, Capitol Valley is no joke. They played a monster schedule, and they put up 34 points a game. They put up 424 yards a game. They have an incredible double threat quarterback, threw for 3,000, ran for nearly 800. You know, they, and I said, they scored. I mean, their schedule, look at their schedule. They only played two teams lower than Division VI. So they went really 4-5-6. They played one Division III team. They played a Division VII team, which was Santiago. Their final game was against a league game against Elizo Niguel, which is Division VIII. But otherwise, I think it was three Division IVs, two Division Fives, and two Division Sixes. So they played a tight schedule on that interlocking, you know, Seaview South Coast League deal. So it's going to be no joke. But I think North, although their schedule wasn't as good, the two best teams they played were Orange Vista and Summit. You know, Summit ratings-wise is kind of in the same stratosphere as Capitol Valley, and North took care of them fairly easily. But I love this game, Jeff, because it's just a matchup of styles. Capitol Valley is going to throw the ball all over the place. They're a high-flying offense. And then obviously North with their defense and with their run game. But again, we talked about this back in September when they played Notre Dame. I have a feeling Jaden Gamble's going to have a say as to whether this game is won or lost for John W. North. But if nothing else, undefeated at the doghouse on campus at John W. North, that's got to be exciting for the players and the coaches and the families and the students. It's going to be a fun time. You got a good rival coming out of there in Capitol Valley.
Yeah, I'll tell you what, just talking to a couple North guys walking around town this week, they said, we used to play Capo in the day. We want to get them again. But, you know, that was back in the day when Todd Marinovich was there. They've had some big-time players and big-time programs come out of Capo Valley.
I mean, Capo Valley has won. They won, you know, it's been a while. They won a CIF title in the 80s, the 1980. They won the Division II title in 1990. But more recently, between, I think, 2014 and 2017, they went to four straight semis. They went to the 2016 final. They ended up losing in that final. But, you know, they've been pretty good in the Inland Empire, though, Jeff. Their last four trips to the Inland Empire, they've won three times in the playoffs. The only game they lost was to Cajon. And the last time, it was Jaden Daniels Cajon. They came out to Riverside in 2016. They played the Division V semifinal at King High, and they were able to beat King. It was a great game, 20-14. But I think this is a great opponent, and it'll be a great showcase for the city of Riverside against South Orange County. I'm sure some Capitol Valley fans will make the trip, so it should be a real fun game.
Well, we're going to have it. You and I are going to be on that call. But let's talk a little bit about my alma mater, the Ramona High School Rams. They've got a home game this week against Valley Chrisitian out of Cerritos. We saw the best of Ramona last week, as I think Hillcrest gave them the best game of the year, and they really responded well. Do you see Ramona going into this game with the momentum to maybe get the first win and possibly play a second home game?
It's tough, yeah. So the big thing is, you know, Valley Christian's no joke. Again, they played a pretty tough schedule as well. Their schedule is probably a little bit closer to Ramona's than Capo's is to North. But they come out of that 605 league, and it's just a lot of rough and tumble for them. But I love that Ramona's getting the chance at home, potentially setting up a second-round matchup, because the other side of the bracket is Temescal Canyon. So if Ramona and Temescal can both win, and, you know, I'm not saying they will, but if they can both pull it off, then a great Division II matchup to showcase some Inland Empire schools. But, I mean, what I like about Ram High is I like their balance. They can run the ball. They can throw the ball. And really, to me, it's going to come down to their defense. How stout can that front four be? You got big Marcus Perez back. He's a big boost. They can get all their defense healthy this week. Remember, they had to hold out a couple of players last week against Hillcrest. You know, run the ball, stop the run, and they'll put themselves in a very good position to win against a really good Valley Christian team.
Well, we will have that game as well. Like you said, Nick Rice, J.R. Ibarra will be on that call. Let's go down to the stay in the River Valley League. The champions, Norte Vista, on the road at Monrovia. That's kind of a shocker. Both teams undefeated. Norte Vista 9-0, Monrovia 10-0. Coach Batdorf and the Ferryman cannot be happy with that seed.
That's a tough draw. But, you know, I think the coach's attitude is we're going to have to play somebody like this at some point. So you're going to have to play a good team at some point. Why not in the first round? And I think the matchup is fairly even. They're both, you know, both undefeated teams. Monrovia coming. What was the league they came out of? It's very river. It's with an R2. I forget what it's called. It's with an R2 before the River Valley League. I'm going to look it up. I'm going to cheat. I'm going to look it up real quick here, Jeff.
The Rio Hondo.
Rio Hondo.
Yes.
They come out of the Rio Hondo League. Yeah. So, and so, yeah, Monrovia was one of those teams, just like Novi. Well, where were they going to be slotted, right? And it depended on the rankings of some of those at-large teams. When I projected, I always projected that Novi would be Division Six. I figured they'd be Division Six. They ended up in Division Six, and I thought Monrovia might be a little bit higher, but because some of those at-large teams maybe pushed them down a little bit, it's going to be a tough matchup. But, you know, here's the thing, is that Ken Backdorf and his team, they're built for the playoffs. Why? They run the ball and they play defense. And I shout Andy Martinez out. I'm sure he's on the chalkboard right now figuring out what to do against Monrovia. And then as far as, you know, we always joke about that line Jim Herrick said to me many years ago. He said, you know, as far as Nueva Vista's offense, easy to scout, hard to defend. So there we go. And the big boys in the backfield, Eddie Elaine and Jesse Carvajal, they've been rolling of late. So can they keep it going?
Yeah, I'll tell you what, the quarterback for Valley Chrisitian has thrown up over 3,000 yards as well and 600 yards on the ground. They're going to have a tough task defensively. Remember, Nueva Vista's only given up 31 points all season long in a 9-game schedule.
Yeah, we'll see. The speed on the back seven is going to be tested. So we'll see how good they'll learn how good they are. I mean, if they can somehow, you know, get a big win against Monrovia, that opens the door for them to, you know, move forward, because they would probably get a home game on that second round game.
And they would actually possibly play Temecula Valley, which would be a great, great.
That's right.
Bert Esposito, former head coach at Riverside, Ramona, Paloma Valley. How cool would that be to have a second round matchup at home for Nueva Vista versus Temecula Valley?
I'm just rooting for home games in the second round. That's all I'm rooting for. All because Novi's the road team, so they would get, if they win, they would get a home. They would get a home game in round two.
They won the coin flip, I was told, so they'll get a home game in round two. Now let's move talk a little bit about Arlington, who, you know, came in with a losing record but got the automatic qualifier. But they have an opportunity to do some damage because they're set up perfectly.
Yeah, they're in Division 13. It's wide open, right? That division is wide open, and they have an opportunity to make a run, and they're playing well again. And it's the River Valley League, right? They run the football. They've been running the football very, very well. They found some things in terms of their offensive line and their running game. And if they can run the football, and they've been playing well defensively too. Their defense has really stepped it up. So the two formulas you need, the two things you need as part of the postseason formula Arlington has, and you tip your cap to the entire coaching staff there. And then the players who, I mean, you know, the juniors and seniors there have been, talk about adversity. I mean, they've muddled through a couple of seasons where, you know, nobody would have blamed them for throwing in the towel, but they didn't. They stuck around, they stuck with the program, and now they're being rewarded. And I hope they can get a home game too at some point.
Yes, great. Great story for a first-year head coach who's really paid his dues around the city of Riverside and the Inland Empire area. And finally, let's talk a little bit about our guys, Bill Powell, John Rice, the head coach at Riverside Poly. What a great job they've done since, you know, they came in with Coach DeWitt a few years ago. They were under his tutelage the first year, but they've really taken that and propelled it. And look at them. They're in the playoffs. How wonderful is that for Riverside Poly?
Yeah, it's great. I mean, they got Division 11, they were the automatic qualifier out of the Inland Valley League. So it's great to see them. You know, Coach Rice, we've known him since, you know, he was at North. And they, you know, it doesn't get easier. Baldwin Park is no joke. The opponent they're going to play is going to be tough. But if they're healthy and they can do what they do, right, they run the football. You know, what is it, RPO, run power often, right? That's what Bill Powell likes to do. But they have enough of a passing game. They have some threats on the outside as well. We've seen early in the season they can exploit the passing game as well, but really it's got to come down to Baldwin Park again, pretty explosive on offense. Can you contain them? Can you figure out a way to muster some resistance and slow them down a little bit? And that game will be a close one as well.
Well, Gasol, we've covered them all here in the city of Riverside. We have a big one, two big ones coming up on Friday night. You'll be on the call with me. And Nick Rice and J.R. Ibarra will be on the Ramona Valley Christian game. Gasol, any last words before we go get off the air here?
I mean, I'm just looking forward to going to the doghouse, you know, to see Capitol Valley, old Southern California, or old South, you know, South Orange County team take on John W. North, kind of little old, you know, little old school football like back in the day when it was like really the OC against the IE, and John W. North was kind of a bell cow in the Inland Empire, and Capitol Valley was in that old South Coast League with, you know, Modern Day and Mission Viejo back in the day, two big powers clashing. And I love the contrast of styles, like you were talking about with the smash mouth football for J-Dub and then Capitol Valley throwing the ball all over the field, you know, and that, whatever, the red gun, whatever you want to call it, the Cliff Kingsbury offense. So I'm looking forward to that, Jeff. It'll be fun to call the game with you.
Well, he's Gasol. I'm Jeff Gorham. We'll be right back with more on the Coach's Perspective here on Riverside TV. And we're back on the Riverside Coach's Perspective here on Riverside TV. I'm joined by my favorite guy in the whole world, the Ramona High School head coach, Ken Mashinsky. How you doing, Coach?
Jeff, doing great, buddy. Hey, great to see you again. Thanks for having us on the show.
Well, Coach, you know, we covered you last week. You had a, I mean, I'm going to tell you right now, one of the best games we saw the Rams play all season. You played, Hillcrest gave you everything, and you guys came out and just played a phenomenal game. What did you, I mean, did you feel good after that win?
I think that it was a positive win for us in more than one way. Their quarterback just came out and lit us up and had a very, very good game. I think he threw for over 300 yards. But it, you know, when you win a game and, you know, things like that happen, you have to take the positives out of it. And the positives are, is, you know, we need to work on some things in our secondary. You know, fortunately, our offense was able to put some points on the board, and defense made stops when they needed to. So coming out of that Hillcrest game, we're going to be a better team. We're going to take another step up the ladder, and that's all we can hope for.
Well, Coach, you know, you guys won that game with, you know, significant injuries. How are the guys? How are they feeling going into the playoffs?
You know what? We're very focused and pretty excited. I would say yesterday's practice on Monday, the coaching staff and I were talking, you know, what was it like with you, you know, in your group, the groups that were very focused. And, you know, for 16, 17 year old kids to say that they're focused on a Monday practice, you don't hear that very often. So that was very nice to hear. We do get quite a few kids back from either concussion protocol or, you know, ailing knees and ankles. As I'm sure a lot of teams are either losing kids or getting kids back, it's week 11. So we're heading into CIF. Everybody's a little banged up and bruised up. I'm looking forward to getting a few kids back and really looking forward to a tough game on Friday night.
Well, before we get into Valley Christian, let's talk a little bit about post game. You know, you coached Travis Carter at Martin Luther King High School. You were his football coach. What did you say to him after the game? Was it more, because I know you hadn't beat Hillcrest ever in the history for you. Was it fun, or did you give him a little smack talk? Because Gasol and I were wondering, is it a smack talk, or do you hug him and tell him, good job, I'll see you next year?
Definitely the latter one. I would never talk smack to Travis at that moment. Now, when we meet for our all-league meeting, when we, you know, maybe go out and have a pizza in a month or so, there may be a little bit of heckling involved, but... But after a game, you know, I know win or lose how you feel. I have a tremendous amount of respect for Travis and all the head coaches in the River Valley League, and just sportsmanship. You don't do that. I gave him a hug and wished him luck, and you know, wished he had still had an outside shot of getting an at large in CIF. So again, it was a great game. It's fantastic coaching against someone that you coached. Albeit 20 years ago, but it was great coaching against Travis again.
Well, yeah, be honest with you, that was the highlight for me, was to see you guys play against each other, running similar sets, and just really the camaraderie and the friendship that I saw between you guys. And it's just it was great. It was palpable. I think everybody felt it.
Yeah, it's great to coach against guys that you know. So, and there's a lot of them. not only in the River Valley League, but around around Riverside and the Inland Empire. You know, you have a good rapport with them, and anytime you get to go on the battlefield and fight against them, it's fun. And you know, win or lose, you come out afterwards and you shake hands and you hug and you're still friends, and it's a great thing. It's a great coaching circle.
Okay, now let's shift our focus to Valley Chrisitian out of Cerritos. Hey, a very daunting opponent. They can throw the football. In fact, I think they throw him for over 3,000 yards. He's run for over 600 yards. Pretty good, darn good quarterback. What do you see in this Valley Chrisitian team?
Oh wow, they are they're loaded. They've played and beaten teams by a pretty large margin. Defensively, they're not. I wouldn't say they're overly huge, but they fly. I could try to compare them to a Norda Vista. I think Novi's defense is a little faster, but their backers at Valley Chrisitian, they are all over the place. Offensively is where they really make their money, though. Number seven is just a real special player. He does it all for them. Offensively, he plays safety on defense. He is the kickoff and punt returner. He's really an all-star for that team. And he's surrounded by a lot of great athletes. So, you know, you try to stop one and they have another one right behind him or a guy on the outside that could catch the ball. So it's going to be a very even game, even opponent. We're going to have to play well to beat them. And I think that they're going to have to play well to beat us. So again, Friday night it's going to be pretty spectacular to get things kicked off.
Well, Coach, you get a home game, and does this season, is it anything remind you of 2 years ago when you guys ended up going to the CIF Championship? Is there any similarities from the two teams?
I don't know about the maybe a little bit with our team, but there is a little similarity going into this game one against CIF. In 19, we played Rosemead High School. We were away, but their quarterback was, and his name slips my mind, but their quarterback was unbelievable. He was fantastic. He was only a junior, and he ran the ball very, very well. He was tough, and we had a tough time stopping him, but we did, and we were able to get away with a win there and get a couple or a few home games after that. So looking at Valley Chrisitian with their number seven, Rocco, he runs very hard, just like the Rosemead quarterback did. So again, we're faced with having to stop number seven. Patriot number seven, we had to stop them. So it's kind of funny the similarities we have. But you know, we faced running quarterbacks before, and our defense is getting healthy, and we're bringing some guys back. With a good week of practice, I feel pretty good going in Friday night.
Well, Coach, we seem like we cover you quite a bit, maybe because I'm a Ramona Ram alumni, but I'll tell you what, it's always great to cover you and the Rams. I appreciate the upward transition that you guys have given the school a good shot in the arm, and we're very proud of what you've done at Ramona High School.
Well, hey, Jeff, I really appreciate it, and you know, I appreciate the fact that you're giving me the credit, but the credit really belongs to everybody. The community, the administration, obviously the boys and their families, just the whole buying into Ramona football. And, you know, I'd be remiss if I didn't thank my wife and all the wives and girlfriends of all my coaches and the coaching staff. It's just great to have that whole family atmosphere and everybody buying in and us getting to, you know, go to the playoffs and have a home game at 9-1. And, you know, who knows if we win this one, maybe we'll get another home game and just kind of keep that home playoff streak going.
Ram pride on the rise. You guys have the school best 9-1 record, Coach. You've done a great job. I tip my cap off to your players, everyone involved. And we'll see you Friday night as you guys are going to battle Valley Chrisitian of Cerritos on Riverside TV. Thanks, Coach Mush. Have a good night.
All right. Thanks, Jeff. I really appreciate it, man. We'll see you Friday night.
We'll be right back with more from the coach's perspective here on Riverside TV. We are now joined by the head football coach at Valley Chrisitian of Cerritos. He's Kevin McCarthy, head coach of Valley Chrisitian. How you doing, Coach?
I'm well. How are you?
Well, great, great. You guys are starting the playoffs week 11. And you're playing against a Riverside Ramona team that just made it to the CIF Finals 2 years ago. Tell us a little bit about what you think of Ramona, your opponent this Friday night.
Yeah, it's certainly a tougher draw than we expected to get, being, you know, a league champion and having the record that we've had recently. We thought we might get a little lesser opponent, but that's not the way it worked out. We got a really great opponent in Ramona.
Well, Coach, you know, Ramona, you know, they've been able to throw the football. They've got a great young head coach, Ken Mashinsky. But tell us a little bit about your program. You've got a great young quarterback yourself who threw for over 3,000 yards. Tell us about that young man in your offense.
Yeah, we have we're really blessed with a lot of talent across the board. The quarterback has been obviously the core of what we've been able to do. You know, in many of our games, he's been the best player on the field and the difference maker. So, you know, I guess in that case, we would kind of go about as far as he can carry us.
And defensively, what do you guys do defensively, and what are you going to try to do to stop this higher-powered Ramona offense?
A lot of prayer. They're real big up front, and the running back's real good, and he makes good decisions, and he's fast. So we're just going to try and play good fundamental football, and I hope for the best.
And can you single out a few guys on the defensive side of the ball that we can look forward to on Friday night?
Yeah, I mean, I've got a couple of good defensive linemen. Ellis Negron is our top point getter for the season. Chris Chang on the inside's real good, a bigger kid. And we're a 4-2-5 team, so we rely a lot on our secondary and our linebackers. You know, we just try and play good, like I said, solid fundamental football and spill things and hope for the best.
Well, Coach, you guys play in a tough league and a tough preseason. Can you tell us a little bit about your season? Because, you know, us out here in Riverside, we don't get to see much of the schools out far away. Tell us a little bit about your team and who you guys face this season.
We took a pretty good beating from St. Paul, game one out of Santa Fe Springs. They're a Division IV team. And then since then, we've just kind of got it rolling. We haven't necessarily played the caliber of opponent, maybe like what Ramona has played or some of the other teams, but we beat a couple of quality opponents. We had some things go well against Village Christian, who's out 8-1 now, Ontario Christian, who's 7-1-1, and had some success against them. But just it's just a matter of a lot of things falling together for us.
Well, Coach, you've been there a couple of years now. What is your strength from your school that you guys, I mean, Valley Christian has been very good for a long time in a number of sports. What is your idea that you bring in your philosophy to Valley Christian football?
Well, philosophically, I mean, we run an offense where we try and get a lot of kids to touch the ball. And to be honest, we're just blessed with a really good system coming up. A lot of our kids are homegrown. They go to Valley Christian Elementary, Valley Christian Middle. They stay. They play multiple sports. I've got 8 soccer players on my team. I've got 7 baseball players, a handful of basketball players. And I'm just lucky that they're also pretty good football players. Only a couple of football-specific kids, but that's just the way that we've been. The way we've been lucky.
Well, Coach, we're looking forward to Friday night. You know, we're going to have a doubleheader as we have John W. North versus Capo Valley and Ramona High School versus Valley Christian out in Cerritos. Coach, thank you again for joining us. We're looking forward to seeing you Friday night.
Appreciate the time. Thanks very much for having me.
He is Kevin McCarthy, the head football coach at Valley Christian of Cerritos. And thank you once again for joining us once again on the Coach's Perspective here on Riverside TV. Good night, everybody.